From our album of the week called Direction of the Heart, that is Simple Minds and Human Traffic. We've got some more traffic in the studio now. Actually, it's not nice to describe.
I'm trying to work out, is that a good or a bad thing?
It's a very good thing.
Yeah, okay. It's welcome traffic. Whoever welcomes traffic, no one.
Well, we have Richie traffic and now we have welcome traffic.
Yeah, okay, fine. I'll take it.
How are you?
I'm very well, thank you. Yeah, in a great mood today for a Wednesday.
Why?
Yes, no particular reason.
No.
Yeah, just feel good, slept well.
Cool.
Yeah.
We've been talking about things that you've eventually got around doing after putting it off for ages. Anything like that?
Oh, there are a big long list. But one of the most recent things is finally cleaning my toddler's car seat. And the turning point was putting her in the car at the weekend and she said, dirty. And she's 18 months. I thought, do you know what? Yeah, I need to clean that now. But anyone with a toddler, I'm sure, can relate. It's, you know, trying to get a toddler through a car journey, you need lots of snacks.
So,
there's just bits of snacks and things that have like a bit of mush banana that's dried up. Not very nice. So finally got round to cleaning that. And it'll be in the same state in about 24 hours' time.
What's going on today?
So, new Prime Minister Rishi Sunak has given out all of the top jobs in the cabinet. We'll tell you who's got what it means and what it tells us about how he will govern. He's also facing his first Prime Minister's questions at midday, so we will see how that goes. We'll talk about what it's like being diagnosed with ADHD later on in life. Now, typically we associate ADHD with children, but more and more adults are being diagnosed with it now, especially women, which is interesting. So if you've been diagnosed as an adult, think you may have symptoms, please get in touch. We'd love to hear your stories. We are going to speak to the woman who discovered Richard III's body underneath a car park in Leicester 10 years ago. A film's been made about it. I know, incredible.
It's unbelievable, isn't it?
I know, it really is. And where buried was an R directly underneath an R for reserved, that space. So you think, oh, Richard, what are the chances?
And who would go and build a car park on top of it?
I know. Well, they obviously didn't know what was there. But anyway, that is remarkable. And
Richard III was when? From when?
So he fought in the 13th century.
Wow.
Yeah, the last of the Plantagenet dynasty. But, you know, we'll give you a little history lesson as well.
Okay,
on the show.
Fantastic.
And are you into online gaming by any chance, Gary?
No, I'm not really a good online gamer. I'm just not a gamer, no.
Yeah, that's fine. I mean, people are in one of two camps, I find. Generally, they are, or they're not. You know, people are into it, or
we're
not into it. No time for that. But anyway, we speak to a man who does have time for online gaming and who invited four people he'd never met in real life to his wedding. He met his mates. He's now very good friends playing FIFA. Their friendships flourished during lockdown. So we'll find out how that went.
That's fantastic. But I guess a lot of people meet each other online now.
They do. They do. And also, if you have children, it's, you know, if you can't physically go out. He had a stag do, apparently, over FIFA, like a virtual stag do, which is quite fun. So, yeah, we'll find out more about that. If that sounds like your life, maybe you've made some friends through online gaming, please do get in touch. You can WhatsApp us, 08000 288 291. It is working today. It went down yesterday,
didn't
it?
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, we all know. text 88291. Or email me, vine@bbc.co.uk.
Thank you, Tina. See you in half an hour.
See ya.